Article 1, Section 3 of the Constitution of the United States says, "The Senate of the United States shall be composed of 2 senators from each state, chosen by the legislature thereof for 6 years, and each senator shall have 1 vote." Now, the states created the federal government in the first place by creating and joining together in a compact called the Constitution of the United States. The purpose of Article 1, Section 3 was to preserve the authority of the states over their creation and to preserve and protect the interests of each of the states. It was also, and especially, to soberly consider the legislations passed by the House of Representatives in the light of the best interests of the nation, without pressures of factionalism from the public. This design of Congress was so important that Article 5 of the Constitution, which sets forth the only lawful method of amending it, flatly and specifically prohibits any amendment depriving any state of its suffrage in the Senate without its consent. Quote, in pertinent part, that no state without its consent shall be deprived of its equal suffrage in the Senate. Secretary of State William Jennings Bryan falsely declared the 17th Amendment ratified when 10 states refused to consent by not ratifying the amendment. It was not ratified. Therefore, the 17th Amendment is null and void for want of ratification, and the United States Senate has not existed constitutionally since 1913. Therefore, a properly constituted Congress of the United States has not lawfully passed any law, ratified in any treaty, confirmed any cabinet-level or judicial appointments since 1913. That's 107 years of federal government lawlessness. Can you say rogue occupation government? Do you think the deep state President Trump is trying to root out by the double handfuls has benefited from this lawlessness? You bet they have, and they don't want to give it up. But there is a way to correct this lawless tyranny, and it is perfectly legal and lawful and proper, and does not require combat in the streets. Well, unless they, the communist insurgents infesting the deep state, start it, but it looks like they're starting it anyway. So that possibility doesn't tip the scales either way. The sovereign nation states that created the federal government by writing and ratifying the United States Constitution are still sovereign nation states. They did not give up their sovereignty when they, together, ratified the U.S. Constitution. They delegated certain specific sovereign powers to their creature and prohibited themselves from exercising certain of their sovereign powers, but they did not divest themselves of those powers. The states, both collectively and individually, still have those powers of sovereignty, and they still have the absolute sovereign power to enforce the United States Constitution on the federal government they created. They have, both collectively and individually, the sovereign power to declare this legislative resolution, the 17th Amendment, is null and void for want of Article 5 ratification, and specifically these facts to a candid world. It is all documented by the plain English text of the U.S. Constitution. Anyone can read it. Once declaring to a candid world the nullity of the unratified 17th Amendment, the states, both collectively and individually, have the absolute sovereign power to recall their existing imposter senators, compel their appearance before their legislature, and officially terminate their commissions as U.S. senators. The state legislator may then officially, legislatively, choose new senators to represent the state instead of the people, compel their oath of office to do exactly that, and send them back to the U.S. Congress to be seated as U.S. senators. Yes, they could choose the same senators if those chosen would swear to or affirm they would represent the state instead of the people, and would adhere to that oath. They could be recalled and fired if they didn't. It should be perfectly clear that if the U.S. Congress refuses to seat these constitutionally chosen senators, the state has a binding and legitimate cause of action before the Supreme Court against the federal government for unlawfully denying the state its constitutional suffrage in the Senate. It would quickly become evident to the U.S. senators of other states, at least the truly Republican ones, that their state would benefit immensely in both power and prestige and economics if they were to do the same thing. Our nation is founded on the rule of law, and the United States Constitution, as written in plain English, is the rule of law. The sovereign nation states that created the United States are the only entities that can save it. Thank you for your time.